Pete and Jacob at the beginning of a pretty crazy day in Silverton. It's very much the case of a taskmaster boss and a rookie, isn't it? If you wonder if you could explain what the relationship is between your characters at the beginning of the film.
I'm a guy who's just come on board, probably not too long before the beginning scene. And I feel like I'm getting kind of involved. There hasn't been nothing going on. We haven't found anything. But then the moment where it starts to get hot and we start getting in, you know, to where we need to be, I don't know what to do. I'm getting on his nerves. He needs me to be on par and I'm not. And he's letting me have it. Understand that Jacob's never done this before. He got hired by his friend Daryl, who's been part of the team for a while. He knows, and it's like, hey, come shoot some tornadoes, get some extra cash. Okay, cool, that sounds awesome. You know, not shooting them, you know, right there, or intercepting them, trying to get right into this thing, and he gets freaked and he's scared, and Pete, he doesn't care. It's all about the shot for him right now, and we have a chance to do it, and I kind of fail, and he lets me have it.
Matt, you're primarily known for your work in comedy, I'd say, but whilst there's some laughs with Pete, it's usually his expense, actually, to be fair. It's mainly a serious role for you this time. Is it more fun to be more dramatic in Into the Storm?
I wouldn't say that the drama was necessarily what's fun. The action was fun. Do you know what I mean? Like doing the stunts and seeing people getting sucked into the sky and running through the elements, whether it's a 100-mile-an-hour fan or rain. Those elements were really fun. And actually, working with good actors like Richard and Sarah and Jeremy, et cetera, playing dramatic moments was fun because there are some sweet turns and things that I don't normally get to do, which I truly enjoyed. So yeah, a little both.
And Jeremy, you've admitted to being a bit of a weather buff in the past, and you grew up in Kentucky where they do have tornadoes. Have you ever experienced anything like what we've seen Into the Storm in real life?
Yeah, I did. I was when I was in first grade, a tornado came through my school, ripped out the gym, a lot of the roofing on the gym, and it was just the scariest moment of my life. You can hear all the sounds, that freight train noise, the tornado hitting, coming towards the school, and then the vibrations and the rattling of the building, the lockers swinging open and stuff. That scene in the school in this movie really reminds me of it, and scary.
Yeah, they are scary.
Finally, guys, if a real tornado were to hit your house now and you have to say one thing,
These are good. If I had to save one thing, my family?
It definitely wouldn't, an
object.
Okay, thank you.
It definitely wouldn't be anything technology-wise, because then...
One thing. Oh, my God. And it can't be a dog? Dog doesn't apply either?
Nothing living.
Okay. If a tornado came and hit my house right now, what would I take? Wow. That's
my camera. My Canon 50D.
I would take the TV.
And the 12 pack in the fridge.
What do I use the most? The TV.
Fair enough, Jack. Supposed to speak.
Thank you, man. Thanks.